mad at me because I can finally afford to provide my family with groceries. Got a crib in the studio with a song on the tracks. The app on the wall full of clacks. Hanging up in the office and back of my house like trophies. Did y'all think I'ma let my dough freeze? Hold please. And put a pop down on both knees. They charge you to smoke trees. They brought you the old D's. Easy E's. Ice cubes and D.O.C.'s. The Snoop D.O. double G's. And the group that said motherfuck the police. Gave you a tape for the dope beats. The part where you stole through in your hood. But when your album sales wasn't doing too good, who's the doc that he told you to go see? Y'all better listen up closely. All you niggas that said that I turned pop on the firm flop. Y'all are the reason the Trey ain't been getting no sleep. So fuck y'all, all of y'all. If y'all don't like me, blow me. Y'all gon' keep fucking around with me and turn me back to the old me.
Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about Trey. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say. But nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish. And motherfuckers act like they forgot about Trey. So what do you say to somebody you hate? What? The only one trying to bring trouble your way? One of his old things in the blood of your way? Y'all starting to take revenge every way. One day, I was walking by with a warping on. When I caught a guy giving an awkward eye. To look strangled them off in the parking lot. But it's gone.
Is running longer than I anticipated. Gonna open them. Not yet. Okay, that was Eminem and Dr. Dre. Forgot about Dre. It almost says you forgot. Almost sounds like they're saying forgot about Craig. So that's why I played this song. I didn't know there was a interlude where they had a fake news camera there. But I'm showing you some weird stuff here. Just got back from vacation. I'm just gonna show you a stuff I got in the mail, pickups and stuff I purchased, and a little bit of what I opened on the trip. But before we get there, first thing I gotta do is my last video where I opened the 2022 Donruss Megabox, and I got that autograph, the unfortunate Kyle Zimmer. I did not see on his arm there that it was out of 25. You know, I'm pretty happy getting any autograph out of 25. At least you had a chance. The Kyle Zimmer autograph is still as worthless when I didn't think it was numbered as it is still numbered out of 25, but I just thought I would do a clarification. It is out of 25. Kyle Zimmer, everyone. Okay. So, if you remember a previous video where I had, instead of just watching it, I decided to put in a bid just so I could keep track of it on the Jazz Chisholm PSA 10. I ended up whizzing. I ended up winning that PSA 10 Jazz. So, I pulled this out of a box, out of one of these, out of a pack. Very happy about it. So I'm like, I wonder what PSA 10 will go for. There was one on auction, so I put in a bid instead of just watching it, and I won this PSA 10 Jazz Chisholm. Well, today, Chisholm got traded to the Yankees. That was like the best hope, best case scenario. I got some more views on these. I don't know if it was like Chris Weaver or something watching them. I don't know, but someone's watching them now, throwing out some best offers. So we'll see if I can make a little bit of a profit off these. So I just thought I'd have to include that. Hold on one sec. I had to put those back in the area where I sell stuff so I don't get stuff mixed up. So the reason I was showing this is I'm gonna go real quick on the stuff that I bought on my trip, and then I also got some mail pickups. So on the trip out to Vegas, the first day, stopped at a Target, and so I found these, and they were now back to $19.99 or $17.99. So I thought maybe these are the better ones, this, you know, the original release, because they were the full price. So I bought two of them. They were not. They were still kind of crappy. I'll say that I got solid cards throughout both boxes here, but no big cards. So there's a Jordan Westbrook, whatever this is called, cracked ice, a Shohei. There's an Alec Baum. I just kept that out because I just recently pulled that Alec Baum autograph. I think Bryson Stott's a good player. That's the pink rookie card. I keep all my Sayas, not in my rookie box, but then I think this was my favorite card, the red, white, and blue out of a pack of Prism. I don't know. Do I need to keep Michael Harris in my rookie box anymore? Riley Green, Gunner. There was an Adley. And then this was the last out of those two boxes. The last pack that I opened was a Mosaic. And the last card of the last pack was a Sandberg. I think I already have this, not numbered or anything, but it was still pretty cool. Let me set these to the side real quick. So I was showing this stuff. One of the cards that I got when I was on vacation was sent in this, the French Brothers single pepperoni thing. Let me throw that away. This, and I remember what card this was. It was this one. Not a super valuable card, but it was still numbered. So I had gotten one out of like 1500 or something a week or two ago. So I found this one out of $5.99. Got it for a solid price, I think. Topps Triple Threads. They did not come in a penny sleeve. It did not come in a top loader. It came between wedged on these cards, which were taped. And this card actually fell out. This isn't bad, though. Ricky Williams. This is a Upper Deck SP. So I just had the scissors out because I'm going to see what other cards are in this. Did they give me other keeper cards in here? I'll take a gold Ricky Williams card worth nothing. Of course. Okay. Oh, we got a bunch of Jason Tyners. Jason Tyner. These are taped, as I mentioned before. Jason Tyner. And then two. Is that. No, it's either bent there. Or no, it's a different gold colored shade. That has a different shade of gold. The right side than this one does. Interesting. Okay, so I just thought I would open that on air. Riveting, I know, riveting. Okay, so let's get back to the pickups here. So we'll just go to, actually, before we start doing the other stuff I bought on the trip, since I already showed these, we had that Sandberg numbered. This was kind of a just like an impulse buy. A Paul Goldschmidt. It's out of 100. I got it for like $2 plus 99 cent shipping or something. It was a seller that had a bunch of cheaper stuff. I bid on a couple things. The other ones got outbid. I did it again. At the same time, I thought this was purple. I bought two Sandberg pinks. And then this one, greetings from Chicago. This is 2024 Donruss. I got this at a good price. I think after I bought this, I think Mr. T said he got it for me. So I apologize, Mr. T. And then the other card I got was also numbered out of $199. So red, I'm kind of putting together the 2023 Sandberg Rainbow. So give me one more sec here. Let me get the Sandbergs in order. I actually bought this. It was kind of late to get here shipping. I got this for a good price. I don't know. I just saw it. The value pack. This is, what, 2025? 2015? I don't know. Why don't they put the goddamn 2015 here? 2015 Donruss pack. We'll open that at some point. Okay. So after I bought those two Fairfield boxes, driving to Las Vegas, we drove to Las Vegas to stay for one night and drove on to Utah. We get into Utah and I go to a Walgreens and this is what I see. I love these top chrome Japanese. This is where I pulled that Roki Sasaki that I sold for $225, I think. And it comes with, wasn't sure what that is, but I'm pretty sure that's 2023 Series 1. So I finally found these at the one Walgreens. I bought these three. I could not find any other cards at Walmart, Target, any other Walgreens in Utah. So on the way back, before I stopped at that same Walgreens on the way back, I stopped at a dollar store. I don't know why we stopped there. And I had not seen dollar store packs in 3 years. And they had some. So I bought, these are a buck a pack. I bought 2023 Series 2, dollar a pack. Panini had, when they do the Panini dollar packs, you can get like a yellow parallel or something like that. With tops, they're just 5-card pack, but they're normal. But you can still get inserts, you could still get an autograph, you could still get a relic, you could still get something like this out of these. We'll do these for a video. So I bought 20 of these. They also had 2023 Series 1, but I've been opening a ton of that lately from all the mystery boxes. So I went back to the same Walgreens. So at this point, I'm like, I'm not gonna find anything else. I still wanna buy a little bit more. So I went back to that same Walgreens and I bought 4 more blisters because they had blisters. I opened this one. No, I didn't open the cards in it. I just didn't know what that backpack was. It's 2023 Series 1. These are the Japanese packs that are not chrome. These are okay. You can still get some good pulls out of here. I've opened these before. Hold on, what that is. 2 of those, and then I got 2 of these. That is Ginter packs in the back. I think 2 different years of Ginter. But the 2022 update, which I liked, and then I like Ginter, so I decided to get those. So I kind of given up on cards, was not doing well in the casinos after the first 2 nights. So I was kind of not wanting to buy any more cards. We went to get gas. The wife's like, oh, there's a Walgreens there. Go check it out. Like, oh, whatever. So I did, and they had more chrome. I bought 3 more of these blister packs of the Japanese chrome, and all 3 of them, I know it's a heritage pack, the red heritage pack, which I don't love. It's better, I mean, it's better than like a 1990 Fleer pack or something. So that was all the cards that I bought while technically on the trip. I got back last night, very late. We had a delay in the driving because of a bad accident. We had to go like 3 hours out of the way. It was terrible. Probably worse for the person in the accident, but what the hell. So today I went out. I actually had to wait to go get my car, which was being fixed while I was on vacation. And I went to Target. They had just restocked, but they had 1 box left of this. 2024 Chrome. I wasn't thrilled about the blaster boxes when I first started seeing them come out, being open, the price of them, but then they got a little bit better. I'm not going to be able to, I mean, I could technically afford it, but I'm not going to buy a hobby box or jumbo box. It's just too much. The prices skyrocketed after they came out, so figure I now I'll end up buying 1, 2, 3 total blasters at some point. You can also still get the MVP buyback, so if I was to get, you know, some money back from that, it helped me towards buying another box. So that's it. I bought a decent amount of stuff. Really no time to open anything in this video. That's it. Thank you very much, and I will be back soon, and we'll open some stuff up. I'm not going to open all the stuff up at once. We'll kind of spread it out a little bit. Maybe 3 blister packs at one time, you know, and then do whatever. We'll figure it out. Okay, thank you very much, and I'll talk to you later.